Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how I edit my YouTube tutorial videos with Adobe Premiere Pro. Now, when I make my YouTube videos, I record with my phone, which also has audio. And then I also use a microphone like this Blue Snowball microphone. And then I also use screen capture recordings, which will pick up the audio from this mic. I also want to say that I came up with this way of doing things, so some of it might not be the best way. But if you know a better way of doing any of the things I've shown in this video, go ahead and drop a comment below. That'll be helpful for everyone who watches, and me too. All right, let's get started. So usually when I record, I end up with three files. I've got kind of a talking head video. This part goes at the beginning and the end of the video. And I record this with an iPhone 11. While I'm recording this, I also record my voice with a much better microphone, which is the Blue Snowball mic. And then I have screen capture footage, which I'm able to record the audio at the same time for this. Okay, so first I'm going to open Adobe Premiere Pro. And then I'm going to come over here to New Project. I'll save this in the same folder just to make it easy. And then I'll type the title of the video. And my setup for these things is okay as is. So we'll say okay. All right, now I'm going to open my Finder back up. I'm going to select all my files and just drag them right down here to create a sequence. And now you can see we've got the three pieces. I've got my iPhone footage, I've got my screen capture, and then my iPhone audio, which is from my Blue Snowball mic. So I'm gonna drag this underneath my iPhone footage. And the reason I do that is because this audio should match up. And to synchronize them, all we have to do is select both, right click, and then go to synchronize right here. We'll choose the audio track, channel one, and say okay. It'll take it a second and then it'll synchronize it. I'll zoom in right here. Okay, now for whatever reason, my Blue Snowball mic does not record very loudly. I need to increase the gain of all my audio tracks. So I'll select all with Command A or Control A on a PC, and I'm gonna right click and then choose audio gain right here. I'm gonna put it at 14. I've tested it, and that usually does pretty well. Now I'm going to delete my phone audio. So to do that, I'll hold Alt or Option on PC and just click that one and then delete it. Then I can select my footage and the audio from my Blue Snowball mic, right click and choose link. Okay, so this is lined up nicely. Now my footage is recorded in 1920 by 1080, so my sequence should also be 1920 by 1080. So I'll check that now. And it is right here, 1920 by 1080. So we'll say okay. Now I usually increase my video footage so that I can cut out these pieces up here at the top and over here. And honestly, increasing the size of your footage is probably not the best idea because it lowers the quality. It's best to shoot in a footage that's higher resolution than 1080p, and then you can decrease it to fit the screen. But for my YouTube tutorials, I'm okay with the quality. I'll click on my footage. Then under the editing workspace, I'm gonna come to Effect Controls, and then just hover over the scale section and increase it a little bit, just until those things kind of go away. Then I'm going to move it down a little bit with the vertical positioning. Okay, and this is looking pretty good. To play the footage and audio back, I always use the space bar to just play and stop. And I always cut my footage using the audio. So I can see there's nothing good up to this point, so I can just cut that out. I can see there's another big space here that I'll just cut out. So I'm going to increase my view a little bit. I'll get right here to where I think the audio is going to sound good. And I'll just test it by hitting spacebar.
Hi, this is Anna with Graphic.
Okay, and that's exactly where I want to cut. So to do that, I'll hit Command K. That's Control K on a PC, which will make a cut. And then it'll also highlight part of your footage. And then I'll hit Option Delete or Alt Delete on a PC to delete that part of the footage. Now, as you're playing by hitting spacebar, you can also hit L on your keyboard to speed it up. And when you hit spacebar again, it'll reset it. And by the way, doing that does not speed up your actual footage, but I'll show you how to do that in a minute. Okay, so I'll click here. And I'm going to make another cut with Command K. That's Control K on a PC. And I'll make some other cuts so the video is separated the way it should be.
Okay,
Now you'll notice on the screen video, I've got a lot of empty spaces, like right here and here, and I always cut those out because they really are blank spaces where I'm either trying to find my place or whatever, and it's no good. So I gotta cut all those out. But I try to record my talking head footage as good as I can so there's very few cuts in it. I think the screen footage, having a lot of cuts in that, is a lot less noticeable than in your talking head footage. Okay, so I'm going to move the beginning of the video all the way over to the front. I'm just going to Command X or Control X on a PC, then move my playhead to the beginning. I'll hit the plus key to zoom in, and then I'll paste. So you can see it's really short, it's right here at the beginning. Then I'll hit A to select everything after that point, and then move it over so it starts in the right place. It looks like a good place to cut the screen footage is here, so I'll do that and delete the extra. And you'll notice the screen footage is pretty small, so I need to increase the size of that. So I'll come up here to the scale, and I'll just type in 150. And now my screen footage is the right size. I usually fade my talking head footage into my screen capture footage. So to do that, I'm just gonna click right between them. You'll see a little red line there. And then I'm gonna hit Command D or Control D. And that will put a cross dissolve in, and that's the normal default transition for Premiere Pro. Now you can change your default transitions, but I'm pretty happy with the cross dissolve. So here's what it looks like with the fade.
Get started. All right, I'm here in Adobe Illustrator.
So I'm going to move over to where I think the next cut will be. It's probably right here. I'll just test it. And yes, this is where it'll be. So I'll hit Command K. That's Control K on a PC. And I'm gonna cut right over here to where the audio starts up again. Now for this piece that I wanna cut out, there's a way to do it so that it'll push all the footage over to the right up against this other clip. And to do that, I'm gonna hit Option Delete or Alt Delete, which is known as Ripple Delete. Now, if you have a list of things you're talking about in your tutorial, you can add numbers and different graphics from Illustrator or After Effects and put them into your videos too. So I want to show you how to do that. Normally to do a number or something, I'll make an edit by hitting Command K or Control K. I'll hit A to move everything over to the right, over a little bit. And then I've got some numbers that I've already created. These are just PNG files. And I'll just drag one right into my timeline. It comes in really big, so of course I'll have to resize it. So I'll just pull this down. So something like this. So your footage will be going, and then you'll have your number, maybe some audio that says number one. And then once it ends, you can just cut that and get rid of the excess piece so it'll play like this. And of course you could click on it and add your default transitions by hitting Command D or Control D to just kind of get it to dissolve in and out. That's a little much, so I'll undo. So let's say you want to speed up parts of the video. Okay, so I'm going to speed up this part all the way to here. The thing is, you don't really want to speed up your audio. It'll start sounding really weird. I'll use my razor tool by hitting Command K or Control K right there, and I'm gonna cut it over here too. I'm gonna hold Option or Alt and click on just the audio and get rid of that. And then we're going to squeeze this in so it plays really fast. I'll hit R on my keyboard, which will bring us over here to the Rate Stretch tool. And now you'll want to get right on the edge of this and move it over so it speeds up that footage. So now when we play this, it starts moving really fast. If you want to speed it up even more, you can do the same thing, hitting R and moving it to make it even shorter. Now you might notice that it sometimes doesn't work. You'll want to zoom in closer on the footage, and then most of the time you can get it to work that way. So after everything's done and you've got the whole video the way you want it, you'll want to render it. So to do that, I'll go to the very beginning of the video or press the home key and hit I for in. In and out is what you'll be setting. Then I'll go to the very end of the video. You can also press end on your keyboard and then press O for out. So we have our in and our out. You can see the difference on your timeline. You'll have these two little blue bars up here and a part of it that's just a little lighter gray. So once you have your in and out selected, come up here to sequence and choose render in to out. And this will usually take quite a long time, but once it's done, then you can go ahead and go to file, export, media. Now I only change a few things here. I change my output name. I just click on that, make sure it's the correct name and that it's going to be saved in the correct place. And then I make sure that these two are checked. I want both the video and the audio. and my format is always H.264. And then I hit export, and that's it. All right, if you like this video, please click on the like button, and I'll see you in a couple days with another graphic design video. Thank you.